Praise the Lord. We're here at WLJC, and this is a room where we answer the phones and try to help people get on a way that they need to get on. You know, I believe what will make it work is when people are downstairs singing and the people up here answering the phones. You know, the Bible said right there in Matthew 9:37, the field is white to harvest and the laborers are few. You know, I thank God for every one of you out there that's supporting WLJC, because this is a lighthouse up on a hill. God bless you and keep backing up WLJC in Jesus' name.
WLJC welcomes you to have church with us for the next 90 minutes during the hour of harvest. Call in your prayer request or praise report now. The WLJC prayer team is standing by to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to our service tonight. We really hope that you'll stay with us, because we believe that it will be, the songs will be uplifting, and the messages in the songs will be an inspiration to you. And we need this from time to time, like day to day. We need new inspiration to keep going. And so as we go into the service, well, you just pray for us and join with us. And as the word and the songs go out, we want it to accomplish what God would want it to, and to touch the hearts that needs to be touched. So we welcome each of you, regardless of where you are. We want you to know you're part of this service. We can worship the Lord together, you in your place and us here, because it's all in the Spirit that we worship Him. So that's what we want to do tonight. I have just a short scripture, because these verses are so good. I was in hopes that we'd remember them better if I just read a few. In Romans, the 8th chapter, starting with the 35th verse, it starts out by asking a question. Who can separate us from the love of Christ? Now, just think about this a minute, because sometimes we feel like we've been separated from everything good, but we have the answer here. Who can separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, or things to come, neither height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Only the four verses in Romans, the last four verses of Romans, the 8th chapter. The question, who can separate us from the love of God? So I believe that lists everything that we are acquainted with, and it says not any of this can separate us from God's love. So that should give us real great hope and encouragement tonight, regardless of how fierce your battle is or what heartaches that you're going through. It still cannot separate you from the love of God. He loves us that much, and that's what we like to talk about, the love of the Lord. All right, Dottie has phone operators. If you need to call tonight, that will be fine. So let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this great fact, this great truth, this great reality, that not anything can separate us from your love. And we praise you for that, because, Lord, everything else is shakable. Everything else is movable. But, Lord, we are so thankful that not anything can pull us away from your love, and Thank you for that love. And so help us tonight in the service to be able to inspire someone to believe more for what you have already done for them, or to heal them, to save them, to deliver them, to be the friend that they need. Sometimes people wind up in this world without a friend at all, but we know that you want to be our friend. And so, Lord, help it to be a revelation to someone tonight that needs it. Bless all of our singers and our phone operators and those that will be calling. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, tonight we're very happy to have with us the Unity Freewill Baptist Choir from over at Camargo, Kentucky, and their phone number is 859-432-5999, and the pastor there is Martin McIntosh, and that number is 859-274-6207. All right, let's welcome right now the Unity Freewill Baptist Choir from Camargo, Kentucky.
Forget that day, March 14th, 1958, on a Friday night about 9:05. I knelt at an old-fashioned altar, and I'll never forget that day. Jesus said he'd go with me all the way, and that's been a long time, and he's never left me. Glad to be here tonight, and glad to have the choir with us. I love this choir. Got two new members here tonight, but we're thankful for that. And you pray for us real hard. We're here that souls may be saved. Last night, Brother Jackson was here. I think they had 5 souls that were saved. Let's see if we can't do that tonight. Pray real hard someone out there be saved. Oh, the glory did roll, our next song. Amen.
I was deep in despair,
had no peace within.
surrender my all.
I surrender my all
unto Jesus the Savior.
Bless His dear name.
Then the glory came down.
I was saved from sin. I was saved from sin.
Oh, the glory did roll.
Oh, the glory did roll.
I was happy and free.
I was happy and free.
I heard a sweet voice.
I heard a sweet voice.
Speak pardon. Job, he does it, doesn't he? He saves us from all sin. Praise the Lord. I believe our next thing on the program, Sister Holland, Naomi Holland, is going to sing a song for us. She has Sister Murray with her, but Sister Murray can't be here tonight due to sickness and things. So Sister Holland is going to sing. We need to pray for Sister Murray. She's got a great job ahead of her. So let's pray for Sister Holland here tonight.
We miss Sister Mary, but we're glad to feel the Lord's presence tonight,
amen.
And yeah. We want to be obedient to Him in everything.
Amen.
What a friend we have in Jesus.
Yes.
All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. Ah, because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful?
Praise the Lord.
All our sorrows share. Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden, cumbered with the load of care? Precious Savior, still our refuge. to the Lord in prayer. Do thy friends despise, forsake thee? Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he'll take and shield thee. Thou wilt find a solace there.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. He told us to cast all of our cares upon him, and he'd take care of them. He'd never leave us or forsake us, but go with us all the way. This song says, I have a heavenly Father. And it just makes me feel good to know that. To know that we have a heavenly Father that made a way by sending his Son into this world, dying for the sins of the world that we might be saved. We might be saved. And thank God forever he's still saving. I know we're living in a time when it seems like everything's falling apart, but heaven's not falling apart. Yeah. Heaven's growing. And he's there waiting for you and I. If you're out there tonight and you don't know the Lord's your Savior, and you feel the presence of God, simply all you have to do is just bow your head and from the depths of your heart, ask God to come into your life and he'll save you that quick. I have a heavenly Father. Amen. Good to be here tonight. We run into a lot of people as we travel around. Some guy the other day and his wife in the store said, hey, I've seen you. And they seen Kearney. He said, you're the one that does that. And it's good to witness. The people says this is their church. They're not able to get out and go to church and so forth. And I'm thankful this goes into homes of people that's good Christian people not able to get out and go. They get blessing from this. Well, a lot of things I like to have, and I sure don't want what the people are running for today. I'd rather be an old-time Christian than the President of the United States, wouldn't you? I'd rather be an old-time Christian And I found that many years ago, and I'm going to hold on to the end. Praise the Lord. Amen. Tried a lot of things down through life, but I found the best when I found the Lord. He found me. He came into the world for me and you and all those that would call upon His name. And ever since then, it's been the glory land way. The glory land way. It's been a happy way, contented way. There's been a few valleys I went through, but I was reading the Bible where He's the lily of the valley. He's the bright and the morning star. He's everything we need. He is the glory land way. Praise the Lord.
I'm in the glory.
There's two ways I read about in the Bible. One's narrow and one's wide. We need to get in that straight and narrow road. Then we're in the way that leads to heaven. He said, I go and prepare a place for you. And I want to see that place, don't you? Someone said, wrote a song, Lord, build me a cabin in the corner of Glory Land. I don't believe he's building a cabin. He said, in my Father's house are many mansions. I'm going to claim one of them. I don't know where I really get it or not, but I'm claiming a mansion. A beautiful place. Yeah, I go and prepare a place for you. If I go, I'll come again. Come again. What's he coming for? After you and I. To take us up to that place up there. I'm in the glory land way. And if we're in that way, our lights are shining. Amen? He said, let your light so shine that men may see the good works and glorify the Father, which is in heaven. So as the next song says, send the light. Amen. You are the light. When he was in the world, he was the light. But now we're the light of the world. Amen. I could preach just a little bit. Karen, get on me though if I did. I better not. Send the light. Amen.
Send the light.
How do we send the light? By the life we live, you know. There's people watching you and I. We may not know it, but there's someone watching you and I. They know when we step wrong way or not doing what we ought to do. We're not sending a very bright light in. The light's gone out. Well, I want to be ready to meet him. And if we keep sending the light and doing the things that God wants us to do, we'll get ready and be ready to meet him. Praise the Lord. I want to be ready to meet him. Our schedule got off.
We prepared so many songs, and always before that number worked out, but tonight it's not working out, so we're going to have to do a few extras. So.
You want to go under his feet?
Yeah, 124.
124. Yeah, I've got a, I had them all laid out here doing it so neatly and nicely, and we run out. Mama, I can't find it. Right under that one, I think. Yeah, there it is. It's right next to it. What about that? If I'd been a snake, I'd been snake bitten. But I'm not afraid of being snake bitten. Under his feet, every problem that we've ever had or ever will have, Jesus went through it. You know? So it's nothing new to him. And he'll take care of us under his feet.
Sister Mary Brown, who's not able to be with us tonight, will want to hear this song. So I'm sure she's listening tonight. And Mary, this is for you. And We are keeping you in our prayers for the times that you're having right now. And you always witness that Christ has gone through everything. And, you know, for us, he's already gone through these tribulations and trials that we go through. So they're under his feet.
Slipping right along there singing a lot of songs. Turn there. Some of them told me one time I talk too much. That's what took up so much time. Well, I'm not as talky as some of them here. Amen. I have a precious friend. Praise the Lord.
I can never forget.
got a little short there. Don't worry, we ain't gonna run out of songs. One more? All right. We got one more. Praise the Lord. Robin, where are you at? Our next song is Tears Will Stop. This Side of Heaven. Well, I read in the Bible where it said there'd be no tears in heaven. No suffering, sorrow, pain, no death. Whoo, hallelujah. Tears will stop just this side of heaven.
Song to think about is there'll be no tears in heaven. They're all going to be this side of that place. There's, that will go for a lot of things that we suffer through now we won't have when we get to heaven. And that's going to make heaven within itself. You know, we talk about all the features of heaven that people look forward to, you know, the streets of gold and so forth. But to just have peace and to no misunderstandings, no one to ever hurt your feelings again, that would be heaven within itself. And that would be something we've never had here, isn't it? All right. We have some requests in. Judy from Lawrenceburg, she's lost her little 20-year-old dog, and she's real sad about it, and she's grieving over that. You know, animal can be a family member, and so pray for her to be comforted there. From Leslie County, for a lady that her husband died in this month, and also she has a diabetes and ear infection, a son that's very sick, and a nephew that's in the hospital. So she has a lot of things making her need prayer. Phyllis is very sick. It says from Hurley, Virginia, the Brittany and Hurley families. Pray also for the Jackson family. Shirley from Montgomery County. Some prayers needed there. Larry just got out of the hospital. He knows the pastor tonight, and can he and his wife sing Heaven? This is says Larry. It doesn't give a last name. All right, a lady from Laurel County for her family and friends, and pray for a lost family. A man who had four-wheeler accident, and also a friend that's had surgery. All right, we'll save the rest of the prayer requests till a little later, but we have a different news arrange news. I mean, I don't think they're going to start giving news over here, but they might. If Emil has any and feel like he needs to, well, he will. But I believe we're going to have more songs, and so some more musical arrangements, not the news, not going to give the news. All right, let's go right back over to the singing right now, and I believe they have a new lady with us tonight, and so we're happy to have her. So, all right, what do we have going over here music-wise?
The Lord has been blessing us, and I want right on time. You know, what's the name of it? Now we've got it. I wanted to witness for the Lord, and just thank Him for His many blessings and His salvation. We can't thank Him enough for all of our blessings that we have from Him each and every day. And I'm thankful for that. I have Robin McLaughlin here singing with me now. Robin is from Charleston, West Virginia. We've got church members and family watching from the internet tonight from there, and I want to welcome them to the program tonight. This is the first time Robin's been here. When I lived in West Virginia, before I came to Kentucky, we sang there in West Virginia together at church. So she's come down to visit, and we're just going to use her because this is her talent the Lord has given her. So we're just going to use her. So we're going to sing a few songs now.
Jesus.
Any time of the day or night, all you need to do is turn your mind toward Him, and He's there, and He'll bless you. It's funny to say, but I was out in the garden the other day. Emil was on his riding mower. I was in the garden just to sweat and trying to pick beans. And the Lord just came down in that little garden, and I was singing to them beans. And I was just a-crying, and Emil was over there mowing the lawn. And it was just wonderful to be able to commune with the Lord that way. You know, Amen. You have to pull yourself aside. You have to give yourself that time to commune with the Lord. And it's such a wonderful feeling. And if you don't know that feeling tonight, you know, we just pray that something might be said or done, that you would realize that you need Christ in your life, and that, you know, we could turn ourselves over to Him and let Him lead us each and every day. So I'm just thankful to be here and thankful for the feeling that I feel. These songs, Lord, has just really blessed my soul tonight. So just continue to pray for us.
Face alone.
Praise the Lord.
Sometimes in your life, you think things are going good. You had a good day and everything's went right, but you still need God. Without God, that day probably wouldn't have went right. There's just so many things that can come upon us in our life. I want to say, I am so thankful Jesus saved my soul. Long time ago, at an old-fashioned altar, went down to a creek and got baptized. So many times a day, you get in a baptistry and you get in a buddy. I got her down at an old creek, and Jesus saved me religiously back then. And I still love him today. Amen. I can remember as a little five-year-old girl singing in the pulpit because Grandpa made me get up here and do it. All I know is what God gave me, and that's just enough. And I praise the Lord tonight.
Amen. I want us to be together in heaven. Amen? Amen? Would you all like to spend eternity with me?
I want to send some requests out tonight, I promise. So
go right ahead, honey.
I can't let them down. Sister Mary Connors always wants us to sing her a song. I want to send it out to my children tonight.
Amen.
Especially the ones that's lost it. Yes. Maybe they give their life
bless
to the Lord before it's too late.
Amen. That's right. Praise the Lord. Someone else.
I would like to send it out to Ryan. He said he'd be watching us tonight.
Amen.
And, Ryan's a good kid.
Bless you, heart.
Thank God for him.
She just joined our family.
Yeah.
We love her
to
death already. Amen.
Brother Emil, I met some cousins of mine that I've never met before, second cousins, and they're supposed to be watching tonight, and their name are Leonard and Marie Neal.
Bless
I'd like to
Lord.
Send a song out to them.
Hey, we're in church.
That's right.
Go ahead and testify. Whatever you're going to do. Well, if we'll all stick together as we are tonight, we'll all be together in heaven, won't we?
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you.
blood is not applied, then in hell you'll lift your eyes. But I want us to be together in heaven. I want us to be together in heaven. I want to march down the streets of pure
Amen. Who's up next? Sister Holly going to sing another song. I tell you, her and Murray in church are just as faithful as they can be. Amen. Praise the Lord. Bless her, Lord. I want us to be together in heaven. Praise the Lord. That'll be throughout eternity.
I'll try to sing, He Knows All About Us. You know, the Lord knows all about us. And I want to do my very best each day to live in a way to please Him above everything. God understands. He knows all about us.
Bless her, Lord. Amen.
He knows of our hope. He knows of our plans. He's willing to help. If we will but follow, He knows all about us. God understands.
Praise the Lord.
I walk with the Lord in sunshine and darkness. I cannot forsake His word and command. Temptations are great, but His love is greater. He knows all about us. God understands. I know of His love. I know of its meaning. I know of His power. He's given to men. Without faith in God, my life would be worthless. He knows all about us.
Praise the Lord.
God understands. I walk with the Lord in sunshine and darkness. darkness, I cannot forsake His love and command. Temptations are great, but His love is greater. He knows all about us. God understands. When troubles appear,
amen,
and life has no meaning, be washed and be cleansed in the blood of the Lamb. He's trusted and tried, so cast Him your worries. He knows all about us. God understands. I walk with the Lord in sunshine and darkness. I cannot forsake His word and command. Temptations are great, but His love is greater. He knows all about us. God understands.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. There's going to be a day that's referred to as a glad reunion day. And I'm looking forward to that day. I think it's last week or week before somewhere we went to a homecoming. And Lord, all kinds of people there from everywhere, people hadn't seen for years and years, all these things. And that's just like a homecoming. But that's just a sample of that homecoming that we're going to have over yonder. Amen. That glad reunion day. Seen and ears are not heard, neither has it entered into the hearts of man, the things that God got in store for us, oh Mary. The amazing grace, well, I got Sister Margaret, one more. Well, it has to be Amazing Grace. That's one of Sister Margaret's favorite songs. Amazing Grace, and how sweet it was. That is the theme song of every denomination in the world, is Amazing Grace. Hallelujah.
Before we sing this last one, I want to thank Don for playing with us tonight.
Yes.
He's always behind the scenes, and we love Don and Margaret. Yes. That's right. And we thank him for playing with us tonight.
Great job from the Unity Freewill Baptist Choir from Camargo, Kentucky. And we appreciate all the good songs that they have shared with us tonight. And I know they have many more. So if you'd like to attend their church, why, I'm sure you'd hear some that you didn't hear here. You've got a mic there behind you if you want to put it on. All right. We have some more request in here. Well, here's a couple of praise reports. Let me give them to you right quick. Minnie says she's praising God. She doesn't have cancer anymore, and she wants to continue to thank the Lord for that. Also, we need to thank the Lord with Pastor Roy Himes. He's doing well. He does not have any surgery scheduled, and he is planning on preaching at his church Sunday, so he's doing well. And so... That Amen. Is great. He's been real sick in the hospital, Amen. But he's doing Amen. Better. All right. Well, we have the pastor of Unity Freewill Baptist Church up here tonight, Pastor Martin McIntosh. And Brother McIntosh, it's good to have you. And I believe you might have somebody you want to introduce to us.
Well, I'd like to introduce my wife. Her name is Sue. We've been together since... July the 2nd.
Newlyweds.
That's right. Hey, after my wife passed away over a year ago, and I laid on my bed and I talked to the Lord, and I said, Lord, you know what I need. And if you have someone out there for me, put her in my path. And he did. Mm-hmm. He certainly did. God is great tonight, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
He's a great God tonight. He's all nipped in the night. And he's all power, as we say tonight.
Yes.
It's good to be here. Good singing.
Would you like to say anything, Sue?
I thank God for Martin. I thank God for the Unity Freewill Baptist Church. My husband was a minister, and mm-hmm. he died 4 years ago. Mm. And I found out God's got good people everywhere.
Yes, yes.
He does.
Yes, that's great. Well, we're glad to meet you, and we know that when he puts people together, it's a good thing.
Yeah. Right.
So, tell us briefly about your church location and so forth in case someone wants to come hear some more good singing.
Okay, we're right in Camargo, outside of Mount Sterling. We're right by the fire station. When mm-hmm. you find a fire station in Camargo, kind of look over to the right there, and we're sitting back a little bit there. Mm-hmm. And we have Sunday school at 10 o'clock Sunday morning. Church service 11, Sunday even at 6 o'clock. And we have a midweek service at 7. We teach. We've been teaching a little bit on Wednesday nights. And so if you like to come, if you don't have a home church, I don't believe in pulling people away from another church.
No, uh-uh.
But if you have a home, don't have a home church,
yes,
then we'd like to invite you to come to our church.
Yes. Well, that's very good. Emil will sing to you, won't he?
Right.
Yes, he does.
Don't have to beg him too long to sing a song. No. So everyone enjoys that. Well, the phone number, do you want to give your phone number to get in touch with you about the church?
Yeah, my number is 1-859-274-6207.
Mm-hmm.
If you'd like to call me anytime. If I can be a help to anyone, tonight as we leave here, God's dealing with your heart, you want someone to pray with you, well, just call me up.
Mm-hmm.
Let me know.
Yes. All right. Well, that's very good. We appreciate the choir being here tonight. From Campbell County, Tennessee, Marie has called and said she needs prayer. From Somerset, a lady for her family has a lot of sickness, and from Mount Sterling, a couple, Goldie and Earl, that is sick. Bertha from Richmond, still needing prayer for her family. From Magolphin County, Charlotte having surgery coming up, and here's an unspoken request. Someone's wife, it says, from Winchester needs prayer. And from Laurel County for Uncle Wesley. He's still in the hospital, and he enjoyed the singing tonight. They did. So, all right. Well, I'm going to ask this pastor and his wife to pray over these, if they will. And if you need prayer, you just join.
You'd like for a minute on one of them?
Yes, that'd be fine.
Yeah.
And that's something that we do, trying to do our part to see that the Lord's blessings will be on these requests. We're about to run out of time, so we appreciate this couple for praying over it.
Our Father, Lord, as we come to you tonight, Lord, you know the need even before we ask. Yes. You know every heart tonight, and these requests have been called in. Lord, we ask you tonight to look down upon them.
Yes.
Tonight, Lord, whatever the situation might be tonight. And special though, Lord, that's called in that don't know you in the free pardon of their sins. Oh God, look down upon them. Help them to realize the greatest need is in their life is the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We pray tonight, Lord, for our granddaughters, husbands, sisters in the hospital tonight. very close to eternity tonight. Lord, that you would look down upon her. If she don't know you tonight in the free pardon of her sins, God, we pray that you would give her another chance tonight. We pray for all whom our duty is to pray for. Just pray for those that's in prison tonight, Lord. And pray for the homes that's broken up tonight, Lord. Across the Erlandon country, many little children is without homes. And Lord, we ask you to bless Sister Margaret here and her effort, Lord.
Yes, God.
And help her and strengthen her. Lord, we realized and heard she had a stroke. And Lord, we ask you to just reach down and touch her body. Yes, God. And strengthen her. Because, Lord, there's nothing impossible with you. You can heal whatever it might be, Lord. You're God, and beside you, there's none else tonight.
Yes,
we pray for this place. Pray for everyone comes here and work, Lord, and for every church is represented here.
Yes.
May the gospel would be preached, Lord, and people would be saved across our land and country.
Yes.
This we ask in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
We pray. Amen.
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 Amen. All right. Thank you so much. Thank
Amen.
You so much. Well, we look like we're about to run out of time, and when we get down to this, well, then they just hurry it up. All right. Well, we trust that everything is well at your house, and if not, just keep praying.
Yes.
From all of us here, we want to say good night, and God bless you.
Amen.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. WLJC is now available on Roku and Google TV. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including the Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed about what is happening at WLJC, along with our monthly musical guest schedule, call 606-464-3600 or write to WLJC, P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Want to hear from us faster? Join our email mailing list. You can sign up at WLJC.com. It's easy and it's free. May God bless you.